Background music and ambience brought to you in part by Midnight Syndicate. Music for the imagination and the perfect musical accompaniment for the Dungeons & Dragons role-playing game.
The leader of Gagmi is dead. The guild as a whole has been dealt a critical blow. The world trembles as portal magic tears at the fabric of reality. Tim and Terry must find the Stable One in order to end the threat from the other realms. And Master Duché has finally acquired the means to conquer and rule this realm as a god. Now, prepare yourselves for the culmination of Campaign 1 as they seek resolution of a fool's quest.
With a sense of urgency, Sir Thadeus Trebilcock scrawls out the teleportation scroll on the ground and lights up the portal. Ingvald rushes down from the roof and makes his way to the portal. Malphaedor moves back away from the portal, back towards where Sir Thadeus was, and Abigail makes her way over to you and says,
"Give me just one moment."
And she takes off, she dimension doors from where she's at to someplace a good, decent way away from you. And then within a few moments, she dimension doors back with the Horn of Abigail in her hands. And she says,
"I think you'll be needing this."
And she hands it over to whoever will take it.
I'll take it.
Okay. So you have the horn, and she says,
"I will train them to the best of my ability, and I will do everything I can to prepare them for what is to come. Before we leave for our task, I will contact you. I do hope you find what you're looking for, and if there's anything I can do to help, please seek me out, and I will do what I can."
Understood. And it is greatly appreciated.
Good luck.
Good journey.
Okay. Bye.
See ya.
All right. So you three step through the portal, I assume?
Yep.
Okay. And in a moment of sheer panic and terror, you realize you are not at the Blinding Bay.
No, no.
You know this because you are stuck in the in-between.
Ah.
Did Abigail the Conqueror just fucking trick us?
Abigail the Conqueror?
Name change.
Go ahead and make an insight roll to see them. This is D&D, so.
Oh, we're gonna get sued!
D&D, fuck it.
I'm gonna use a metal one, even though that's definitely a mistake.
15.
Okay. Thaddeus, roll Arcana as well.
That's the only one I chose, is it?
Flaccid 20.
Oh.
Yo.
What is that? 18, 16?
16.
16 plus 1.
Okay, so you're all fairly confident that she did not try to fuck you over with the book, that the book is legitimate.
Probably just goofy portal magic.
Sir Thadeus, with your Arcana roll, you recognize that there is a disruption in the spell and that it was disconnected by the ethereal plane. Stepping through the portal, you step through the ethereal plane to get from one place to the other.
Right.
The spell was disrupted. So you could travel the way that you've learned how to travel in the ethereal plane to where that portal door is by focusing on the runic image.
But do we remember how to get through without blowing it up? I don't know that we do.
We just have to get to the other end of that portal.
Yeah, but
it should be open, right?
We got to the other end of the portal to Mike's, and we couldn't get through it, and I had to do the teleportation circle, and we destroyed half the city. I don't think we should probably do that again to Blinding Bay.
That's a sacrifice I'm willing to make.
What if Magno is in the blast radius?
No, that's
that'd
too,
be very unfortunate.
Too dangerous.
Yeah, and
well,
I don't.
Let's go to that spot, and then okay. We'll see what we're encountering.
All right, concentrate on the rune for Blinding Bay and hope it takes me where I need to go.
Okay. I will let you guys roll your checks for this. So, you can either do Arcana to be able to get where you want to go, or if you have something else and a good reason as to why it will be effective for you to transition to where you need to be.
What about persuasion to persuade you to let us get there?
Can I persuade God?
Plus 10 on intimidation. Get us to hell out of here!
Do I have any... Do we have any inspiration points?
Everybody should have one inspiration, yeah.
Alright, I'm gonna use my inspiration because that was not a good roll. It's better. 22.
Okay, 22 will definitely get you where... It will get you to that rune.
Okay, then I'm not going to waste a roll.
No.
You still have to get there, too.
You all teleport.
What is it again?
It's Arcana, unless you can come up with a better reason why you could get to where you were. So, like, last time you had that scroll that you had used.
I don't have any items, as we never established the things in my pouch. All right, I rolled a 16 by accident. What can I use that for?
No, yeah, Arcana will get you that.
Okay,
yeah.
That... I use that.
You
just
lucky
dropped
fuck.
It by accident.
What did you get, Malphaedor?
I got 19.
Okay, wow. All right, so.
We live by accident.
Well, I guess I can delete that whole paragraph out of my story. Fuck off, guys.
Hey, no more E3.
Fuck you, the dice gods are on our side today.
You arrive at the location, in fact, about 50 feet away from the location where this rune is. You can see it as a beacon out 50 feet away from you, knowing that you could just move yourself to that, but... The reason you stop short is because there seems to be something impeding your way. With your Arcana rolls, you would recognize that you can't really teleport into the same spot as something else. The physics of the in-between just won't let you do that. You cannot occupy the same place as something else. So it gave you kind of a buffer room. And what you see is the rune... just floating in the middle of the in-between, and a beholder is smashing its tentacle against the glass, trying to get through this side and into Euphrae. As you realize this, you see that the tentacle starts to warp the glass and begins to push through from the in-between into Euphrae. So he's much like the demons that you just saw coming from Banehold. This beholder is trying to enter the world.
So do we call her already? Is that just like giving me immediately? Hey, whoa, already fucked.
What if we? Well, I mean, beholders are genius intelligence. Why don't we just? Can you move, please?
I don't think he's just gonna move out of our way.
Intimidate him or persuade him?
Just be like, look over, like, look. Hey, stop.
Can you just let us through before you try to get through and destroy the world?
Dibs.
One side, coming through.
We're going to have to fight it.
Just come up like a Captain America. On your left.
Coming through.
Do we have any, like, we don't have any, like, catch-all murders, though, now. Like, we don't have any just like, random items that kill things.
No.
We used all of our random trump cards.
Yeah.
Beholders are above normal power levels here. We usually have something for this. It took us 3 seasons to prepare for killing the last one. It's a lot of seasons.
Well, this isn't an ethereal beholder. It's a normal beholder.
Oh.
That's a whole other story there. Thank you.
Sorry. Let me crank my dick a little harder. Jesus.
I mean, the challenge rating is a difference between of 3 levels. So, I mean...
Oh, between fucked and super fucked?
No. Yeah.
We didn't roll my wild magic.
Oh, shit.
When I cast my fireball.
It instantly kills the beholder.
Better remember to do that, huh?
It's not a 1, so.
Yeah, all right. We're good.
It's not a 1. Heard.
It's a 14, but it doesn't mean it. 1 is the only thing I have to worry about.
So you said we're 50 feet from this beholder, right?
Yep.
What's the effective range of a beholder's eye again?
300 feet, I think.
A lot.
That's further than I can throw it.
150 feet.
Oh.
Haha, that's not further than I can throw a dart. Thank you for that. I appreciate you.
Yep.
Figuring that out. I can throw a dart further than that, we've established.
But you're currently only 50 feet away.
But I can just randomly move because we all have this weird spatial thing going on that is the ethereal plane.
Yeah, but we're gonna have to kill it.
I'm a ranged fighter unless I don't have to be. So I'm going back.
Well, let's all roll up initiative then.
Are we fighting it? I guess as a group.
We don't really have any.
Yeah,
other...
we're killing this. So
we're not gonna ask it to move.
I guess not.
Okay.
I mean, if you want to try to intimidate it, or
do you? Should we get a surprise in while we have time to surprise a beholder?
Well, if anything, I can get next to it, give you guys advantage.
I don't know what else we're going to be able to do.
Hey, friend.
Excuse me.
But yeah, if you want to try to talk to it, go for it.
Pardon me, do you have any Grey Poop on?
I'm going back up to 150 feet away from this beholder, as he's probably going to die. So I'm going back there. My initiative is a 5. 5 for Ingvald.
Okay. 19, 5.
Is a 17.
Ooh.
Nice.
Oh, someone's trying all of a sudden.
Mal, the beholder, Thadeus, then Ingvald.
Yep. That's fair. I'm the coward that ran away. I deserve that.
Yeah. All right. So you guys are 50 feet away, and it is Malphaedor's turn. What do you choose to do?
I'm going to cast a minor illusion far off to the right of a another beholder, giving like Zerbert noises like to it.
Okay.
To see if I can distract it and
get it to move away from the
portal.
Does it have to make a roll to?
It can use its action to examine the sound or image. The creature can determine that it's an illusion with a successful intelligence investigation check against my spell's save DC.
All right. So you create that illusion on the far side of the beholder, or like just on the other side?
Off to the right.
Yeah, just okay. Out of the way.
All right. So it hears it. It turns its head and blinks away from the portal to where the other beholder is. And it is going to do the investigation.
So it'll be a DC 16.
All right. So it...
Does it move closer to do the investigation?
Yes. Yeah.
Sweet.
Yeah. And so it got investigation, its intelligence. That's 21. But I'll say it wasted its entire turn doing that, and it immediately went into like a defensive mode. It didn't quite attack, but like it blinked over right next to it and like to confront it, and then it might be, you know, trying to communicate with the other beholder and then realizing it's not communicating back. Yep. So that's its turn.
All right, guys, we're on a truncated timetable. Let's move.
Okay. Any idea how to work the portals from this side?
Not a fucking clue. You're the magic man.
So we have one turn to get through the portal. Oh, God. And Mal can't even move.
I'm going to... It's my turn now, right?
Mm-hmm.
He's floated off.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to go up to the portal and try... Just use my finger, I guess, and trace the sigil for Bright Bay, whatever the fuck it's called.
Blinding
Bay. I don't know why I can't remember that. I'll just draw the sigil for Blinding Bay and see if that...
Are you trying to infuse it with magic like you did the teleportation rune?
Sure.
Okay. All right. So I will let you make an arcana check as this is happening.
You're checking to see if that was a bad idea.
Right.
Well.
Because it was, but like you're about to find out if you know that.
We did that before. Actually. We saw what happened.
26.
Okay. So you start scrawling it out, and as soon as the power starts to go into the rune, you notice that the rune does start to warble with just a little bit of power that you put on this side.
Yeah.
But you know before you finish the rune that it's about to go nuclear and explode again. So I will give you, with that arcana check, the ability to stop the casting.
I will
stop
drawing that then.
Are you allowed to do anything
else? In my 26, did I think of anything else that might... I know after the game he told us how to get through, but I don't remember because I didn't think I'd need to.
So you could tell with the beholder he was... activating a small level of magic to push through the portal slowly.
So
you have to infuse casting, yourself with magic?
Using the amount of magic that I would use for a cantrip.
Maybe another arcana check to deduce magical mechanics of what you spells. Need to do.
Wait a second, I'm not magical, basically. I have magic beer.
I don't know, I've got prestidigitation. It seems like it would be a pretty low level, low power spell. So I'll...
On your next turn?
Yeah, I guess I'll try that. You cast prestidigitation while drawing the sigil? Okay, I guess I'll try that, assuming the beholder doesn't come fuck us up.
And it is Ingvald.
All right, I'm going to, I guess since the beholder is... how far is the beholder from the portal now?
How far away can you cast that image? I assume you wanted to do it as far as you could.
At range. It's 30 feet.
Okay, so 30 feet to the right. You guys were 50 feet away from the beholder.
Total feet?
Well, no, because you wouldn't have wanted to cast it right behind you, because then it would have to go through you
to
get to
the side.
So it's, I would say, about 50 feet from the portal altogether, and maybe, you
kind of like
far away, so.
Skirted around him.
Maybe like 120 feet from you.
Okay. I'm not going to piss him off, so I'm going to go, I'm going to blink over to Thadeus at the portal and attempt to, yes, I would communicate with him to maybe a small amount of magic to get through. My beers are magic, so I'm going to attempt to use my mug of beer to push through the portal first.
Okay, so you magically know what Thaddeus was thinking.
No, I said I asked him.
Okay, all right.
Seeing between things happen here.
So go ahead and try pushing your mug in.
I roll for that?
Yeah, you're going to roll an arcana to see if you see it working.
It's like the wooden plate glitch in Skyrim.
Such things until something happens. I got a 15.
Okay, so you start to press your mug against it, and you feel your mug start to crunch up against the portal. It does not have the magic attributes to be able to open the portal.
That's bullshit.
Sorry.
Was that an action or bonus action for that? Just full action?
Well, it's a movement action to get there, and then your action to try to activate a magical item. Yeah.
Gotcha. Then I am going to prepare my... prepare to move should the beholder close in on us, I guess.
Okay.
That's going to be my last. Just kind of sit there and get ready to run like a coward.
Okay. And Malphaedor.
So am I aware of what he was attempting to do?
I guess. I mean, why would you be... What would have made you aware?
Was he, like, you know, verbalizing his thought process out loud when he was doing this?
I was probably mumbling to myself. I don't know how much you would have picked up, but I'm sure old people talk to themselves.
So, obviously, you haven't done your thing on the thing. So, Thadeus, what's up? Come on, we gotta get going.
I was trying to draw the sigil, and I felt the portal start to break like
time
it did. And
we don't want to blow this one up.
Yeah, what no, we got? Don't. So I guess a little bit of magic.
A little bit of magic.
Yeah, I guess that's
hits it with all the magic.
Second level spell.
Cast smite. Hit it with your hammer and cast smite. I'm sure it'll be fine.
It smite.
No.
Boo.
Just for shits and giggles as a cantrip, I'll do a minor illusion of a door.
And it activates the doorway.
And use my action the rest
we
of my
are
to take my movement.
Smart as fuck.
Well, you already used your action to make your movement to come over here.
Oh, yeah.
So
oh,
you
cool,
can't
we're just
go
standing
through.
By an open door now?
Yep. So that was your action and your movement.
All three of us turn.
And with you guys chatting.
Whispering. Stealth?
I mean, I rolled a nat 18 plus 2, so that's a flaccid 20 on the beholder.
Beholders have a lot of eyes. They actually have zero ears, so I don't understand.
they saw the word coming out of my mouth?
Yeah. One of the eyeballs twisted around to check the portal doorway.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, there you go.
Makes a roll for bullshit.
It's right here, guys! It's plus two. All right, so...
Wise.
It sees you do that, and it blinks just past you guys, and just enough that it hits the portal and goes into Blinding Bay.
Awesome, we released it into the city.
Now we're going to have to fight it anyways.
All right. Well, at least it's on our
This turn. Is what we get for not just instantly killing everything in front of us.
Yeah. I think the last time you guys did this, I said all you had to do was cast like the light cantrip on the portal. And you guys could activate it because everything has way more power.
6 months ago.
Yeah. All right, my beer has as much magic power as a light spell.
You have to be able to cast a spell, though.
You could burp at it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, I could have burped at it. That's a level two. That's a level two spell, though.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Or three spell.
Yeah. The nuclear stinking cloud.
All right. So,
my turn.
It is your turn.
Will pulling myself through the portal be my action?
Yeah. It would be activating it. Well, no, we could say it's movement if you want.
Yeah.
Because being that close to the portal.
Yeah. I used it as the action for the beholder, but I'll play nice and say, say
good,
it's movement.
We just released a fucking problem.
Yeah. Okay, I will pull myself through the portal, and where in the city are we? Like, right downtown, in a random building?
Out in the woods, in the mountains?
You are in a city. You know that you are between two buildings right now, and it is a cobblestone road. Right before you move into that portal, though, and find yourself in Blinding Bay, Stefan Bling appears behind you guys.
Oh,
my God. It took me so long to figure out how to breathe.
Oh, shit. I forgot.
He's gasping.
Stefan.
He's like, I couldn't breathe, and then I needed to breathe, and then I needed to find you guys.
Sorry, Stefan. I forgot you were with us. A lot of stuff going on.
Try to keep up.
Yeah. We didn't expect to get stuck here.
Yeah,
but just come through the portal, and
everyone
then
just turns around. Did you want to write a story or not?
Fucking hide because there's a beholder on the other side of this door.
What?
You see that? Don't let it see you. Let's go.
You can't see the beholder. It went through the portal already.
No. Hey, what is your worst nightmare, Stefan? You're about to find something worse than that.
All right. So then Thadeus goes through the portal, I assume. And,
yeah.
And yeah, so you see yourself in kind of a nice looking city landscape. People are running, so there were people on the street. Not a lot of people, but you see probably 7 or 8 people beelining it as fast as possible away from this beholder.
Okay.
So are we behind the beholder then?
He is behind the beholder. You guys are still
in between. Yeah. All right, lightning bolt.
Thank you so much for listening. We need to take a quick moment to flip it on over to the B-side, so sit tight and relax. A Fool's Quest will be right back.
Hi, excursionist. I'm Nari. Do you know that stories have a way of taking you into a different world? Why don't you join me at the Into the Night Anthology podcast? We present you with bite-sized stories that make you question what you thought you knew.
I may have something that would interest you.
Everything gets old. So someday, as long as it's cared for, any item will become an antique. That includes you and me. And sometimes terrify you with what you didn't.
What's happening? This can't be real.
You can see us. But you are powerless to stop us.
Bring a friend along when you find us on your favorite podcast directory, and make sure to follow us on Twitter at Into the Night Pod so you never miss an episode. Remember, you should never wander these twisted paths alone. In fact, look, the first path is just ahead. Are you ready? Follow me.
Thank you all for listening to A Fool's Quest. As an additional way to connect with us and to help support the show, you can become a member of the official Creative Typo Patreon. Membership has its privileges and includes ad-free episodes, early access to new episodes, access to art, music, and lore, merchandise giveaways, Discord perks and status, special bonus episodes, and behind-the-scenes content you won't get anywhere else. And with several amazing podcasts under Creative Typo's umbrella, you have access to all of our shows with only a single membership. Currently, all proceeds will be reinvested right back into our shows, bringing you even more of the quality content we've enjoyed sharing with you. And there's plenty more on the way. And if Patreon just isn't your thing, no worries. You can continue to enjoy all of our shows just as you have been. Patreon is completely a bonus for those who would directly like to support the show and connect with the cast. To check out the Patreon details, including subscription tiers and benefits, just go to patreon.com/creativetypo or follow the link at our homepage at afoolsquest.com. And remember, stay safe, we love you all, and most importantly, stay foolish.
Microphones and Monsters is a Cthulhu D&D actual play with a balance of horror, mystery, and comedy. Our story begins in a 1920s Magitek noir setting. We follow the story of Alistair.
That power is very much something that I need, and I don't want that to stop.
Victor.
I don't think I want to help you.
And Julian.
It's burning. What happened here can't see the light of day.
As they come face to face with eldritch horrors.
I don't think you could ever stop me.
And try not to fall into madness. Go to microphonesandmonsters.com or listen wherever podcasts are found.
From the indie podcast creators that brought you Microphones and Monsters, A Fool's Quest, Ethereal Embrace, and other hit podcasts, comes a new actual play podcast, Dread Tech Incorporated. Set in the futuristic cyberpunk setting of Dark City, our three DDA special agents, Nitz with his drone Blip, Sylvia Rivera's the shape-shifting social media icon, and Zaus, the Zug heavy gunner, take on the evil corporation Yogg-Sonic Dynamics in an attempt to bring the heinous actions of the corporation into the public spotlight. But will our heroes be prepared for the unworldly supernatural horror that lurks below the corporation's front? Follow Dread Tech Incorporated wherever you get your podcasts to find out.
Oh yeah, the flip side is spinning and the villains are chilling. Let's get back into it on A Fool's Quest.
Now, let's join the drow rogue Ayda, the gladiator bard Francis the Lion, and the rogue warlock Hesh von Eggars as they conspire together to thwart the progress of those gag-me fools. Beware, there be villains here.
Alright, well, Splatter's dead, Moan is dead, Squeal turns around, and,
Wasn't Gush dead?
Yeah, Gush is dead too. Yeah, Gush was number five, though. Alright, so Squeal turns around and lets out a squeal as a battle roar, and goes right after Hesh.
Oh. 23 to hit.
And all three miss. And then Gasp lets out a big gasp and runs to attack Hesh as well.
It's still 23 to hit.
Yup, and one of them hits.
I'm going to use my ability. When a creature makes an attack against you, you can use a reaction to impose disadvantage on that roll. And if it misses you, your next attack roll against that creature has advantage if you make it before the end of your next turn. So, disadvantage for that attack.
Nice.
So, okay. So roll one more time and see if it's lower.
Yep.
It's lower.
Okay. Yep. So I have advantage on that person for my the end of my next turn.
Gasp. Okay. Gasp. All right. And you hear the door above you open and footsteps start running down around the stairwell and come out onto the landing, but it was their full round action to get down there too. So they are there, but they cannot attack. But they are flanking the last two orcs.
So they're like in the way there.
Two gag me guys. Yes.
Their cloaks and everything.
Yep.
Okay.
Big old cheddar cheese cloaks.
All right.
It's my turn.
It is Hesh's turn.
Just bonus action disengage. Every time they missed, Hesh was like,
stop it. Please don't.
In abyssal, like,
knock it off.
And then the disengage is me, like, pushing his face. Parlay. The disengage is him, like, kind of, like, pushing his face and just, like, walking away towards the balcony where the Lordly Might is. And then turning around and then firing on Gasp.
Okay. With your Blundergus?
Yep. So I have advantage. It's a nat 18. So... 25.
25 damage?
25 damage.
All right, so you killed Gasp. So Gasp just goes, and then?
He inhales a bullet to the face.
And his head explodes. All over the gag me boys.
And then the last thing is I'm putting my hand on the Lordly Might to, like, collapse it to retrieve it.
All right, so your movement is to that, but you can't. Is it a bonus action to activate that? So
it requires attunement.
Oh, it requires attunement.
To actually hit, like, the button or anything?
To use it, yeah.
Oh, okay. Well, yeah, so my hand's just on it. Yeah, okay. Like, I'm going to retrieve it for
yeah,
him.
So you're pushing the button, and it's not working.
Just clicking.
He makes it look so easy.
It's red, though. I'm pressing.
Ayda, there's one person left. Squeal.
I will attack with my slap dagger. Real quick, like... 19 to hit.
That hits.
Ew. For 6 points.
All right. And Sebastian.
That rolled so slowly. 10.
10 is a miss.
Yeah.
Oops.
For, what does he do? Just an unarmed strike? Is that what he said?
Yeah. Because he's a buttle monk. A monkler.
He would try to punch him once in the gut. And he would kind of like, and then he tried to punch him in the face, and he would like, the other way. So he'd like, dodge both attacks.
Seeing those gag me guys, behind these orcs just really makes me think about that blue dragon we killed. And I learned something from that dragon. As my bonus action, I'm going to use the Gift of the Chromatic Dragon, which allows me to infuse my weapon with one of the following damage types: acid, cold, fire, lightning, or poison. We're going to go with lightning, since that's what I'm most familiar with as far as dragons. Does an extra d4 damage to the chosen type when it hits for the next minute. And then I'm going to attack him with my whip.
Okay.
Twice.
Lightning whip.
Yeah. And that's definitely going to hit. And that's going to be 2d4. 5 physical and 2 lightning.
Okay.
And then the second attack, whips don't do much damage. The second attack is also going to hit. That's an 18 to hit.
Okay. Then you kill him.
Oh, good. That's a 5 more physical and then 4 lightning. And it's just going to just... like wrap around, he's gonna catch it on his arm, you know, and we'll wrap around and just electrocute the shit out of him till his eyeballs sizzle or whatever, something gross, I don't know.
You ever microwave someone from
the... That's the last orc, right?
Yep, that's the last orc.
Alright, then I'm gonna just grin at those gag me fellas, just a big grin, just stare right at him.
It's all in the reflexes.
The first gag me person you see is an elf guy, and he smiles really big back at you and sheathes his sword, and he's like, oh, sorry we couldn't get down here as fast. We were quietly moving the furniture away that we had used to barricade the door, but it seems like you guys really saved the day. I'm really happy that we saw you. Thank you for coming. Who sent you?
Hesh, I'm hitting the button, but it's not doing anything. Do you have to turn it on and off again?
You're Hesh.
Oh,
Yes.
Yes, I'm not you at the moment. You fellows, wait right here. I'll be right back.
Hesh, help.
I had to go out there and just like just give him a thump like you would, you know, electronics that need a little adjustment. Just thump him on the side of the helmet a couple of times. I'm Francis. You're Hesh. Look, you just gotta. There's a button.
Buffering.
I'll just do it. Just push the button.
Please hold.
Into a rod and hang it off my belt again.
But you did have to turn it on and off again.
Yes, that's really all it takes. All
right. I'll go inside the room as well.
The Elven Guard is looking at Ayda and says, "So, who sent you guys here to save us? I didn't think anybody would be coming. I thought we were kind of a lost cause after the portal disappeared."
It is the orgasm.
Where did these orcs come from?
A rift opened up down in the basement, and they just, a whole bunch of them flooded in. It was the same moment that the portal up here went, just disappeared.
The portal up here disappeared, the rift opened in the basement. Listen, the ones outside, we had a little chat with them. What did they say? Something about a bridge?
They're waiting for a bridge to be made so that reinforcements and Lord Fuckwad will arrive.
Yeah, okay.
Do you know anything about what that would mean, a bridge?
No, I mean, when the portal went out, that was our path back and forth to Cheddar, and it was the same. I don't know if you are familiar with this, but it's the portal that was in Mike's dive, and then the portal just fizzled out, and at that moment, a rift opened up, and these orcs came through and just started slaughtering the people who were in the tower. Then an earthquake happened, and the giant chasm that you see outside it expanded and wrapped around the tower. It's just me and my friend.
You'll get there. I believe in you.
Geraldo, who,
classic,
made it up to the top floor and barricaded it in once we realized we were the last people alive. We hid and hoped for reinforcements just to be able to tell somebody what happened. We are really surprised to be alive.
How have you survived?
It's only been a couple days since they took over.
So you have rations and provisions and safety measures in check?
We have water upstairs, but we don't really have food. I'm starving.
Orcs are probably edible. I'm surprised you're still wearing your gag me cloaks after the fiasco at that Battle of the Bards we heard about.
What happened at the Battle of the Bards?
You might want to take those off, and also take this.
And I split a day's ration between the two of them.
Oh, thank you. And he starts eating.
Listen, it's come to light that the leader of the leader of your organization has had some rather shady dealings. It turns out that your entire organization was led by an evil dragon.
True.
What's that thing's name? Am I real?
Questlinger?
Yeah, that was a dragon.
Yes.
A blue one.
Well, he rolled insight and critically made it. So he trusts. He has a good read on you. Like, he's got really good ability to read.
What about
people.
Me?
You're in a robot.
So. I am in a robot.
So. Now,
he can't read your face.
I don't know if you saw that trick I did with the lightning there.
I did. That with the whip?
Yeah. I couldn't do that before that Battle of the Bards. You see, I am a bard.
Oh.
You've probably heard of me. But it doesn't matter what my name is at the moment.
Francis the Lion.
They work for Gagme. I'm Francis the Lion.
Work for no one.
But you know what? You don't work for Gagme anymore because Gagme is gone. I learned that trick after I slew that blue dragon that was in charge of Gagme.
When all the Gagme failed, Francis did not.
Indeed.
So who sent you here then? Save us?
We're passing through. We wanted to check on the status of these portals because they seem a danger to the world. And, well, we wanted to check things out as Gagme is clearly not to be trusted, any remnants of them anyway. We thought we'd take it upon ourselves to, you know, ensure the safety of everyone. We're real, real helpful folks, us. Good Samaritans.
It's going to be safer if you took off the cloak.
They take off the cloaks and they put them in their satchels.
You
You don't have to, at least by my standard. But it may also be safer if you stick with us.
Yeah, I mean, sure, do you know how we can get back to Cheddar?
Let us worry about where you're going.
What?
We will get you there safe.
I mean, if you're not going to Cheddar, we'll split up and go our own way.
It just does, like, a very obscure pose, like Captain Morgan looking off in the distance.
We'll be sticking around here for a little bit, just to make sure things are safe.
Yeah,
here with the portals and whatnot, you know.
The portal's gone. There's so those runes on the ground there, it used to be when you'd put a magic item next to them, it'd kind of like draw the magic power from it. But it's not doing that now. It's not drawing any magic. They look just like drawings on the ground.
Yeah, I was a little worried those would absorb my spells.
Do you know how to destroy them?
No, I mean, I don't know how to destroy a portal.
The rift that opened in the basement, it's closed now?
Yeah, that wasn't like a portal like what this is, or one of the permanent portals. It was just like a tear in reality, and these orcs came rushing through from some horrible-looking plane and started slaughtering us. And then the rift closed just moments later. It was just enough to send a small contingent of orcs through.
Are you magic users?
I'm not, but Geraldo is. Geraldo.
Do you know Dispel?
Geraldo, do you know Dispel?
Yeah, I know Dispel.
What about that spell?
Hey!
I don't get it.
You wouldn't.
Can you dispel this circle at, like, fifth level?
I can do that. I can try. There's nothing to dispel, though. There's no magic in it.
Okay.
He goes over and casts Dispel. Nothing happened. Like I just said it would.
Should we maybe destroy the circle, the sigil?
We're supposed to take control of it, right?
We need to have control of the tower.
The tower.
But as I said...
The mission was to take control of the tower because it had the very first permanent portal.
Yeah, we probably shouldn't destroy it.
I was just making sure that the added on, it was for the portal.
Yeah, so like full disclosure, me as a player, I know. But also, Hesh is trying to keep Duché from getting power.
Yeah.
So.
How far is it to the Mike's dive?
Oh, that's back in Cheddar.
And how far away is that?
Thousand miles.
A boat ride and, I mean, probably a few weeks on the boat.
Almost a month.
Do we know any other locations of portals other than Mike's dive?
That's a really good question. You do know of at least one that has been rumored that you would know about. Are you asking the Gagme guys or are you asking your party or are you
the
just
Gagme
thinking
guys.
Yourself out loud? The Gagme guys?
Mm-hmm.
Was there one that was rumored to be in the... Was it Oblix? What's the...
Yeah, so Mount Obix is
Mount
where
Obix.
There was a portal. But that one got closed during the...
But would we have heard that hearsay in our travels?
I mean, but you might have. But even if you did, you heard that it got closed. So it's not...
Right.
Yeah. And they kind of look at each other, a little confused face on their... Or look on their face and... And Starving turns back to you and says, the only other one that I know of is the one that we use for Gagme training. The one that we use to pass the final trial.
Where is that?
In Cheddar as well, at the Gagme barracks. It's in the basement.
How long has that been the final trial of the Gagme training?
I mean, at least 100 years.
Oh, so it was Gagme's fault.
That's what I've been saying.
So, if that was 100 years, we're here because this was the first portal, but that one technically wasn't it?
Yeah, this portal just opened up last year.
Yeah, so that would be the first one.
So then, was he wrong in his wording when he told us to go protect this?
He was specific about Maraxi's tower, but I wonder if he doesn't know about that one. No, he's former Gagme.
He has.
Well... there's probably a reason he wants us here. He probably didn't know this portal was closed, though. I'm still worried about these orcish reinforcements that we're talking about when the There'll be a bridge. And reinforcements will come through, right?
Right.
I think we should check out the basement.
Yeah, I think we definitely should go down there.
So, you fellas, do you know how many orcs there were?
I mean, by the time we hid, there was maybe 20, 25, but I think some of them died while they were building the bridges.
And we've killed probably all the rest of them.
From my understanding, if we're supposed to go for the first portal, then to Cheddar we go.
Yes, I think so.
We're taking M with us. Yes, we can absolutely loot the hell out of this place.
In the one-armed, one-legged, one-eyed orc?
You mean my M. My beautiful M.
It's waiting for you to say she's still got both eyes.
And a lovely beard.
Not for long.
Say that out loud in front of these two as well. Like, Hesh wouldn't... These people are no consequence to him.
Do you have any magical trinkets? Anything Gagnon gave you?
I mean, just our cloaks that you told us to take off, and then these swords.
Those swords, they would have opened the portal or triggered these runes before?
These swords? No, they're masterwork swords.
What did you use? You said something magical. And you've used these to travel.
Trigger the runes or whatever.
What did you use?
We're just soldiers for Gagny. I mean, we're not even like real soldiers for Gagny. We're just adventurers. We're two people that go out and recover lost artifacts. Like, we're only here to help back up Cheddar's city guard with this here. So we weren't the ones opening and closing the portal. The portal was just here. It was just open and closed. But if you left your magic items too close to those runes, it would absorb any magic from it. So like, we had to walk in and move away from the portal as quickly as possible so it didn't drain the magic from our cloaks. That's how we know.
I see.
Alright, this is the deal. We're all going to Cheddar, and from here until we get to Cheddar, you will be Ada's wards. Whatever Ada needs, you will do. Whatever Sebastian needs, you will do.
Nope.
No, dude. Yep. No, absolutely not. Yep. We are Gagmi, and just because Gagmi was corrupt, we understand that.
But doesn't exist anymore. But
we don't just serve somebody as a man. We're not slaves to be traded from one organization to another.
Like, big over, like, metal palm on faceplate.
We will travel with you to Cheddar if that's where you're going, because that's also where we are going. But we're not your servants.
Potato, potato.
Geraldo, you're with me, right?
Yeah. Fuck that noise.
Like, whispering as loud as he can.
Pretty big for having blown his spell slot. Alright, to the basement we go. Is there anything in the attic?
There's a really big telescope. It's pretty cool.
I'm into that.
Can't see any apartments with it.
You go. Maybe you can't.
If you want to go to the basement, I'm going to go up.
Yes, I think I will check out the basement.
I will stay with the Gagmi. Me and Sebastian will babysit.
Alright.
With keen mind, I'll just make a very mental note of the last thing that this telescope was pointed to.
Okay. It's just a specific constellation. It's used for wizarding.
Okay. And then, are there any notes or anything
of
relevance?
No. The wizard at Maraxi's Tower died a long time ago, and then Whispers took it over.
Okay. All right. Yeah, that's it. Right. He was just curious.
So, Francis, you go down the flights of stairs and end up in the basement. It is flooded in water, and so it smells like really musty and awful. But what are you looking for down there?
Just any evidence of where this rift opened up, and if I can find where it opened, I'm going to look around to see if I can see anything that would have triggered it. I'm worried that's the bridge.
Do you have any abilities to help you with this, or...
Do you have proof?
+9 Arcana.
Okay, so roll your Arcana and then roll an Investigation. DC 15 for Arcana, DC 12 for Investigation.
Okay. That's a 13 on the Arcana.
Okay.
And that's a 22 on Investigation.
Okay. So you find some weird scorch marks that are directly where, or under where the summoning portal would have been if you were to go straight up. So with your 22, you're pretty confident that this is a straight line down from where that summoning portal would have been. But that's all you can tell. You don't know what it means.
How long does it take for me to get down to the basement with him?
I mean, you went upstairs, he went downstairs, right. So probably a couple minutes.
Okay, yeah.
I mean, you made note of the constellation and, yeah.
I mean, it took me a minute to, like, look through, see if there's any notes and stuff, too.
Yeah, so. You have to search around.
Yep, I was wondering how long I should wait until.
So, Ayda, the two Gagmi guys are up there, and Geraldo's like, your friends are kind of pushy, aren't they?
Friends is a strong word.
There's nothing up here.
Traveling companions, yeah, they have their own ideas about things.
We didn't mean to be offensive about not wanting to be your slaves, but I feel like that's kind of a slap in the face.
Oh, you have no idea how much of a slap in the face it is. But anyway, you would not have been in my employ anyway.
Oh, is this guy in your employ?
No.
Oh. Ooh, okay. Fancy.
He's just treated very well.
Thank you, m'lady. All right. Francis, are you done in the basement?
Yeah, I think so. I can't make much out.
All right, so just as you start to come back up the stairs after doing your investigation, you can see Hesh coming down the stairs.
I'll stick around. I'll point out, you know, what I noticed. There's these scorch marks seem to be directly below that summoning circle upstairs, but I can't tell anything about it, whether it's going to open here again. I would assume it'll be in a vertical line from there, if it does. But that's just a guess at this point.
To move the face mask. Yeah, I mean, you know, from my years of study in academia, I would say... I'm just kidding, I never got any education. I would probably have a wager that this is a symptom of the excess use of the portal. That a tear happened, you know. Unless there's something here or someone here that's going to give us any more information or any more artifacts, I simply don't think there's anything here for us.
So I think you're right. I think we should head to Cheddar to check out that first portal.
Yeah, maybe even make sure that Gagm is true and dead.
Yes. Yes, that's a Always on the docket, I think. But,
the lip on those two. I'm just going to say it. I know we're going to have to travel with them, so I'm going to get it out now. But the lip on those two, after all we did, we came up. You know, it's fine. It's fine. But also, disrespectful. Faceplate comes down.
I'm going to have an NPC save your life at some point. Just save your life. Just randomly, an NPC. And then he's going to be like, you serve me now.
Save
follow
your
me,
life.
Slave.
That means I own you.
Yeah.
This is the way.
Hash logic is so fucked up.
Can I just cast fear on him? That's
the trick. I'm always scared.
Okay, all right. So you guys get the gag me dudes, and you grab M?
I'm going to put M in a big satchel. Like, I'm going to wrap her up in a little...
You're going to carry around...
I'm going to put her in my bag of holding.
In a Bjorn. Of an orc.
You want to put her in my bag of holding?
It's the best 75% of an orc you can have. And I'm going to put her into a big Bjorn that I make. And then I'm going to strap her on the mech.
What?
And I'm going to carry her.
He's like, look, there's no one to speak abyssal with, and if you don't use the language, you lose the language.
Right.
We all know that. If you're not speaking it frequently, you're not going to be able to practice.
Where are you kids?
he's singing.
The thing's probably got diseases. And
how to save a life the entire time, just like singing it to himself. He's like wrapping her up in the Bjorn, just humming it.
This concludes this episode of A Fool's Quest.
Join us next time for more fun and daring adventure. Thank you for listening, and don't forget to like, subscribe, review, and comment on your favorite platform to listen to A Fool's Quest.
Alright, so to start next session, we will be heading back to Cheddar some way. We'll have to look at the map and figure out which way you want to go with two Cheddar Gag Me guys who aren't wearing their cloaks and three quarters of an abyssal orc named Margaret.
No, it's M now. She doesn't know it yet, but it's M.
If she's three quarters of an orc, her name gets shortened too. It's Margaret. It's Margaret.
Margaret. Took off the et.
All right, I'm stopping this.